the number one athlete in the league.
The numbers he is putting up are absolutely staggering.
Westbrook down the lane, throws down over the right hand tomahawk dunk. My goodness.
Westbrook line drive, nails the three.
To take another money ball. Westbrook's got his triple double.
Triple double, triple double. Get used to that.
Westbrook's 15 triple doubles this season.
Westbrook is really doing it on his own. He's the runaway MVP.
Russell Westbrook messed around and had a triple-double just about on a nightly basis. Yet, he's not an all-star starter. Explain that. The star Thunder guard was left out in the loaded West. Warriors player Steph Curry and Kevin Durant, Rockets guard James Harden, Spurs forward Kawhi Leonard, and Pelicans center Anthony Davis getting the nod as the conference's starting five. Now, Russell won the player and the media vote, but he finished third with the fans. He finished about 280,000 behind Curry and about 200,000 votes behind Harden. And since the fan voting was the tiebreaker, Westbrook was left out of the starting lineup. So most people deserve, he believes, to get the start. Stephen A., I want to start with you here. Who should he be bumped for?
Westbrook should be bumped.
Who should be bumped for him? Sorry, I didn't ask that right.
Who should be bumped for him?
Yes, there you go.
Steph Curry. Mm-hmm. And as crazy as that sounds, we're talking about a reigning two-time league MVP. We're talking about the babyface assassin. We're talking about the greatest shooter I've ever seen. We're talking about a guy who deserves all the laudables that you throw in his direction. I love me some Steph Curry. He's a special, special brother in every sense of the word. But I look at the team that he has, the support that he has, and the absence of the load that he has to carry. And that weighs heavily with me, Max. When I think about Russell Westbrook and the kind of year that he's having, I also think about the fact that he has to have that just for the Oklahoma City Thunder to be what they are. 25 and, you know, 19, you know, 7.5 games behind Houston with James Harden, which is why James Harden would be my league MVP right now and Westbrook would be number two. But there's nothing to take away from the greatness of Russell Westbrook and what we're seeing from him. He's a walking triple-double. We all know he's averaging 30, 10, and 10. He's been absolutely sensational in that regard, even though those turnovers need to come down to some degree. But he's carrying a load. And what really, really cements my position right now is what I saw the other night when they got blown out for the second time in as many meetings at the Oracle against the Warriors. I saw an individual in Russell Westbrook who fully believes that he's on the same level as everybody and anybody you want to pick on the Golden State Warriors. Nobody else on Oklahoma City believes that about themselves, and they have no business believing that about themselves. He is a one-man wrecking crew with a minimal and limited help who's doing what he's doing. Whereas with Steph Curry, his resume cannot be denied, and nobody's questioning what he can do. But based this year, despite averaging nearly 25 points on 46% shooting, nearly 40% from three-point range or whatever, to witness the efficiency and the greatness of a Kevin Durant, an underappreciated star in Klay Thompson, along with that of Draymond Green, along with the culture and cohesiveness and togetherness that they have in Golden State, I can make the legitimate argument that there's a significantly lesser load that Steph Curry has to carry this year, particularly the first half of this season. And for Russell Westbrook to do what he has done, and for him to clearly be one of the top two candidates for league MVP honors, he should be starting. But the fans, obviously, their votes are 50%, media's 25%. Players are 25%. Players need to take the voting more seriously, by the way, with some of the nonsense that they threw out there. That might have helped. But Russell Westbrook was even with Harden and Steph Curry. But when you're even, what tips the scales is the fan vote, because the fan vote holds more weight. And they wanted Steph Curry instead of Russell Westbrook. They have the right to. But if it were me, Russell Westbrook should be starting. Steph Curry should be a reserve.
Well, I mean, by the traditional way of thinking about it, you're right. But let me take it a step further. Because in reality, I think you're wrong. Let me start with there before I reveal my pick. Let me start with that. Look, this is an all-star game. An all-star game is going to end 199 to 198. It is all sizzle, 100% sizzle, 0% steak. Now, to your point, of course, Steph Curry's on a much better team. That's basically what you're saying. Yes, we know that. Westbrook has no real juggernaut second offensive option, and the Golden State Warriors, by contrast, are a well-oiled machine where, you know, Klay Thompson turns out to be at best your third option. You know, one of the greatest shooters ever, who once dropped 37 points in a single quarter, is at best your number three offensive option. So obviously, Steph Curry's on a better team. And, by the way, that's part of the reason that Westbrook puts up the numbers he does. Because when a superstar is all by himself, at least in terms of offense, his numbers are jacked up. They're inflated. Which is why I picked Westbrook to win the MVP this year. And everyone knew it was going to be Westbrook or Harden. And that's exactly what it is, because they have less offensively around them. So by all those ways of thinking about it, you're right. Steph Curry's out, Westbrook's in. But why think about it that way? Since it is an all-star game, since it is all about the sizzle and not about the steak, since it will be 199, 198, and since the NBA went away from forcing people to vote on the center position, because what wound up happening is inferior players, and more than that, boring players, were being selected instead of more exciting, better players. They said, well, get rid of the position. A lot of the positions are kind of just made up anyway. What's the difference between a shooting guard and a small forward nowadays? Or even when you're playing at least four out, a power forward and a small forward for that matter. A lot of these are just kind of invented positions. For that reason, here is the Western Conference All-Star starters, the way it really should be. And I know you can't vote like this, but this is the way it should be. It should be Westbrook, Steph, Harden, KD, Anthony Davis. Who gets left out is Kawhi Leonard. Were I constructing a roster to actually win a championship, Kawhi Leonard has got to be on it for the Western Conference. But that's not what this is about. We're not trying to win a championship here. We're trying to make an all-star roster. And the fact that you can't vote the team that everyone would actually like to see, the team that deserves to be there, Westbrook at the point, Steph at the two, if you want to call, name the positions, put Harden at the three, who cares? You're playing four or five out at times. With KD at the four and Anthony Davis at five, that's obviously your Western starters. Why it has to be so convoluted doesn't make sense. So the answer is Kawhi Leonard out, Westbrook in.
Well, again, the reason I disagree with you in regards to that, and I think you're being very, very inconsiderate, is because we're ignoring various positions. Certainly, if you're talking about all-star game, sizzle, names, you want as many guards on the court as possible. Well, congratulations with that, Max. That's so brilliant of you to say. Who the hell doesn't want Harden, Steph Curry, and Russell Westbrook on the court at the same time? Of course, I'm saying, of course we want that. But last time I checked, you have guards, you have forwards, you have centers. Like, for example, on October 23rd of 2012, the NBA announced that starting with the 2012-2013 All-Star Game, centers and forwards would be combined into being front court players on the ballot. A guy like DeAndre Jordan, for example, went ballistic about it because he felt like centers were being disrespected because they were being omitted. We know that DeMarcus Cousins is the best big man in basketball. DeAndre Jordan is a monster. We get that. But in terms of sizzle, Max, and let's get into a macro conversation, but try to keep it tight because I know that's hard for you. Here's the deal. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Well, I make different points as opposed to feeling the need to have the last word. I give that to you, but here's the deal.
Do you believe in this? Are you ready for this?
Molly, can I speak?
Listen. You know what?
You tend to interrupt when I'm talking in the middle of my point.
It's impossible not to interrupt you.
Are you ready for this?
Yes, yeah. We're ready.
Max Kellerman, based on your theory, do you realize a legitimate argument could have been made that if the rules were that are in place right now were in place back in the day? Do you understand that Kareem Abdul-Jabbar might not have been an all-star?
He'd have been the all-star every year.
Time out. He may not have been, because as dominant as the Skyhook was, it's relatively boring. And as a result, you might want to pick somebody else.
No, you wouldn't.
Even though we all know that he has the most unstoppable move in the history of the sport. Kareem would make it.
Shaq would make it. All those guys would make it. DeAndre Jordan would. Time out.
That's not true. And you know why? Because, again, Shaq may have made it not just because of his dominance, but his showmanship. What you're alluding to is showmanship. I'm saying I don't want to ignore, not that you're wrong about Kawhi Leonard, I just don't want to ignore what he brings to the table.
It's an exhibition.
I don't think that's fair.
It's an exhibition for the fans, by the way.
It doesn't matter.
You know who won't when they combine the exhibition
is a celebration of what they did when it wasn't an exhibition.
When they combine the positions, which, by the way, are already combined. There's no such thing really as a small forward or a it's already kind of a BS categories, but when they combine the position,
it's not true.
Karl Anthony Towns will make it. Embiid will make it. Watch. Porzingis will make it. Anthony Davis will make it. DeAndre Jordan won't. Not because he's not good, because he's not great. There are levels to this. Let's face it.
I'm totally in agreement with you. There are levels to this. Let's take DeAndre Jordan into consideration. He can't play a four. He's a five.
Right.
DeMarcus Cousins can play the four,
but he's better
as a five. What I'm saying to you is this. Yes, it's an exhibition. You're absolutely right. But the reason the exhibition takes place is a celebration of what you've done leading up to the exhibition in real competition. What the NBA has done by combining all of these categories into a front court player, the front court players have been complaining. They get omitted for their level of production because of what the NBA has done. It's incredibly unfair to centers that you would omit that position. It should be a center, two forwards, two guards.
So
there's no
since
doubt
you chewed
about
up
that,
the clock, do
right.
I get last word? Is that the way it works?
Go
you
chew
up the clock and
Go
I
ahead.
Get last word?
Go ahead.
That's the most exciting players in the game, brother. This is the all-star game. Take the best and most exciting players and give the people what they want. Westbrook, Steph, Harden, KD, Anthony Davis. Done.
No, but I'm not really disagreeing with that point. I'm simply saying is that you're talking about give the people what they want. I'm saying fine. Just recognize it's unfair.
Okay,
Recognize that it's not fair to those guys.
Let me say right here, for the record, if it will satisfy you, it's unfair. Life's unfair.
All right, gentlemen. Are we good?
That's all I'm saying.
Can we move on?
We're good.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we asked our Twitter followers to vote between Steph Curry and James Harden on this one. 74% agreeing with Stephen A. that Curry should be left off for Westbrook. Max, you're changing the game with your rules. They couldn't vote on Kawhi.
No, they couldn't. I'm talking about a more perfect world.
Yes. Yes. Coming up, the theme of the day. Will Cain is going to join us to talk about which playoff quarterback he has the faith in. You know, this is going to get heated. Plus, stay tuned for when Big Boy joins us. You know, he's going to have a lot to say about a squad from the ATL. We'll break that down in a few.
Hey, this is Shaquille O'Neal, the one who taught Stephen A. Smith everything he knows. And you're watching First Take. Hi, Molly.